Hey, good morning, good morning. Welcome, Mark Abens here. Welcome to The Daily Dose. I probably thought it'd be wise to put the episode is episode number 5. We're in day 5 of The Daily Dose. Now, let me just share with you why I'm doing that. Actually, I'm going to give a moment or two so people come on. I'm listening to a really awesome song right now. I'm going to share some good music with you. This one is actually really, really good. It's called They All Good That I Like. Of course, it's my opinion. This one's called So Will I, 100 Billion Times. Let's just listen to that for a second. Such a good song, such a good song. Yeah. You should go watch these, check out these lyrics too, such good lyrics. Yes. If creation sings your praises, so will I. Awesome, awesome. Let me turn that down because you can go listen to that. But I'm going to have that in the background. Such a good, good song. Let me just turn this down a little bit. Oops, not all the way off. There we go. Cool, cool. Hey, welcome, welcome to the Daily Dose. I want to give it a moment to see if anyone jumps on here live, whether you're watching this live or the replay. I do appreciate you coming on here. Just let me know, just so I know that you're here. Give me a little thumbs up. Give me a little hello. Good morning. Let's be social. Yes, maybe they say social distancing, but we don't really have to be socially distanced. We can be physically distanced and connect. So why am I doing this daily show? Just honestly started it Monday, and I'm calling it the Daily Dose for this reason, because at the end of the day, we're going to have daily doses of some things, daily doses of news, daily doses of our kids being in our homes while they're homeschooled, you know, while they're away from their regular school, a daily dose of stress, a daily dose of aggravation, a daily dose is, there's lots of daily doses. So what I wanted to do is provide a daily dose of encouragement for you. If you haven't seen any of the other ones, go back and check the other episodes. Yesterday, we talked about fighting back. So if you want to learn about fighting back and my thoughts and you'd like those, go back and check those out. So I'm doing this for that reason. Also, the other thing is, just so you know, on a side note, I am a coach. I'm an online health and fitness coach. I help specifically moms and dads over 40 who are trying to lose weight, get their life back, get their health back, and do so without long workouts and impossible diets. Now, if you want information, you want some help on that, just go ahead and shoot me a message after. You can shoot me a private message. You can shoot one down below here. If you have my phone number, you can call me as well. If you want my phone number, we can arrange that as well. But today I want to share with you about calming the storm. And I got this on. I don't know, honestly, it was a little cold. I went outside for a moment, and I'm not even obviously outside. I'm in my office. But I want to share with you about calming the storm. It actually is something, and you may be like, where do you get this? Where do you come up with this stuff? Well, I have time in the morning. I spend quiet time. My morning starts about 4:30. I've been really good 4:35, even now when schedules are kind of all over the place. And I don't know if your schedules are kind of jacked up right now. Maybe your work schedule. My wife's work schedule is different. My kids' schedule is different. They're all here. I'm usually home doing work, and I still am, but I had to adjust my schedule a bit. Workout schedule, sometimes I go to the gym. Well, now I can't do that. Most of the time I work out at home, so that's okay. But here, so there's lots of storms, and I'm going to share with you about the inspiration I got this morning, because I was thinking about the storms in life. In fact, in my quiet time, I did some reading in the Book of Matthew. I'm just going to mention that a little bit later, but for now, I wanted to and by the way, on a side note, if you enjoy this, if this is something that you find of value and you find could be of value to somebody else, the only thing I ask is that you share this with somebody. You can share it to your page, share it in a private message, share a bit of encouragement, because I can tell you in times like now, from what I'm realizing, is we can all use some encouragement. So whether you're the encourager or you're the one that needs to be encouraged, if we can all do that, I think we'll all get through this far better than we will if we're being discouraged and being aggravated and frustrated and disappointed and mad. And those are all good feelings. But I would say if that's the main part of what's in here, then unfortunately that's going to be hard to work on this as well. So my hopes in this daily dose is to give you a dose of encouragement. One of the things I've been doing for the past 25 years is encouraging people in their health and fitness journey. And there's definitely not just a physical transformation that occurs. There's a mental transformation developing new habits, getting away from old habits, getting rid of weight, getting rid of maybe even toxic people who are bringing you down. And again, my job is not to take those people away, just to encourage you to look at other ways when it comes to being healthy. And there is a mental health as well to this. I'm not a psychologist. I don't have all the answers. In fact, I don't have a lot of the answers, but I have a lot of answers, not a lot of all the answers. I certainly don't know a lot, but I've been around this earth for 47 years and I've lived, I've had some experiences. And I want to share with you one of those storms. Actually, two instances I was thinking this morning. First one is when I was a kid. Let me pause or just turn this down a little bit here, because I don't want to talk over that. So one of the storms, I remember being a kid, and I grew up in Long Island, out on the east end of Long Island. It is a fairly affluent area, to say the least. But anyway, my grandfather was a potato farmer, and we lived on a farm. In fact, I was the fifth generation to have been raised on this farm. Now, when my grandfather was there, it was a potato farm. I think I got like dog fur. Potato farm, and I see like this little dog fur thing, Owen's fur. Growing up on this farm, being the fifth generation, my grandfather had chickens. They had like, I think, 1,000 chickens at one point. And, you know, he went through all the depression and all that. And while I didn't experience that, I know I've heard stories about it. Those storms back way back then. Now, when I was growing up, I remember Hurricane Gloria. Now, this is prior to cell phones. We didn't have, you know, up north, we didn't have air conditioning. We had fans and stuff. And we lived in a 200-year-old house. It was on about 20 acres of property, and I would say is we had animals, and we had, you know, there was chores that we needed to do. And despite there was animals that relied on us. And there was, I remember, there was a couple of storms that we went through, but this one I remember, I think it was Hurricane Gloria in the 80s, I believe. I can't remember the exact time. Hey, appreciate you coming on, Janica and Debbie and Gordon and Veronica. Thanks. Welcome. So with that, in the storm, I remember my dad being a builder. He boarded up. He put plywood over our house, and it was lots of two-story house, and he had to board it up. But here's the deal. During the storm, when Gloria came through, the only thing, and I wrote this down because I had to remember what it was called. Now, you've heard of and you've seen probably barometers, but back in old days, they had these liquid barometers. And I remember what we had was we had to rely on, you know, of course, the news, which is way different back then than it is now. And I'm not going to go there with you about news and broadcasting and all that stuff. But we didn't have cell phones. We had a landline. We had a regular home phone. If anybody younger watching this right now will know as far as the home phones. But we had that. And I remember my sister and I really like hearing this wind come and storm and just like blowing. Now, we felt safe because we were in a house that has weathered storms, and my dad made sure it was secure and he kept us calm. And that was something that I'll never forget, looking out of one of the cracks in like the side crack between the wood and outside in the yard. And I remember my sister and I were like looking and watching trees fall down. And we had big trees, none on our house, one leaned on our house, but we had big trees. And it was a huge cleanup, but we got through it, right? And one thing I think as a kid, I was in the comfort of knowing that my parents were making sure that I was safe and secure. You know, they were calming our storm as kids, just as you may be doing that right now. So I just wanted to share that. And then the second storm, actually there's lots of storms in between, but I want to share with you another like physical storm that came up. And this, while this is not necessarily a physical storm, it pretty much feels like it. What's going on right now in this whole world? And so the next one was, I'll remember, we've been in this house now, the same house as the first house my wife and I got married, and we moved in here in Atlantic Beach, Florida, which is the north part of Florida and outside of Jacksonville. So if you're kind of looking at geographically, so we've been here and there's hurricanes. We're close to the beach. It's hurricanes. We've had, you know, the scares. We've even boarded up our house, and I'll never forget one time. And it was in, let's see, Hurricane Matthew. So that was 2016. In fact, I have a video that I looked back and had to look at the date and make sure I had the name of the right hurricane. So Hurricane Matthew came along and it was a scare. You know, we kind of have the warning, kind of like we are where we're at in this virus, although it's kind of all over the boards. But same with a hurricane. You kind of know it's coming, but you don't know which way it's going to go. You don't know how bad it's going to be. And I'll never forget when we came up from when we were figuring out what we needed to do, we decided to go inland more where we weren't exposed and the hurricane would come on shore. And if the tides come up, it could flood our house, take our house down. And we were really scared. We didn't take much. We shipped off inland just maybe about 30 minutes into my mother-in-law's house. And then What we realized, we started to watch the news and we started to freak out. We started to get really scared, really nervous. So what we did, and was really probably not smart of us to do, our kids were there, you know, they were safe, you know, our pets were safe, and we had a dog, two dogs at the time, they were safe. And then we came back and we started to like take things that were like just stuff. We started to like pack up like pictures and pack up like things that we thought were valuable to us. And I remember doing this video and just like taking, because they said for insurance to take a video of all your stuff in case it's damaged stuff. And at the same time, we came on and I did like a little selfie video. I didn't even share it with anybody. And I just shared about how our faith is really what's going to help us no matter what kind of storm we're in, and just being a believer and understanding that God's got this. Whether it takes our house, we'll rebuild, we'll figure it out. God will make sure that we are provided for with what we need. Maybe not the things that we want, but the things that we'll need. And even if that is like circumstances get worse, we'll be able to provide because we have our faith. And that was something that really like held on to me during that storm. And so I want to say that to just share with you during this particular storm. Now, it could be related to a number of different things. Maybe you're scared for your health. Maybe you're in a bad place. And physically, maybe you even have some symptoms and you're kind of scared to go get tested. You might get quarantined. You know, maybe you're out of the country right now and you're worried about your family in other parts of the country or outside of the country. Maybe you have little kids and they're driving you stir crazy and you don't know how long they're going to be home for. There's lots of storms going on, right? I don't know if you can feel me. Give me some thumbs up in there. In fact, I would love this to be interactive. I feed off of that. Those little pulses, little thumbs up, little high fives, if you will. Go ahead and give me some of those if you are maybe going through a storm right now, because I don't know anybody that's not at some point. In fact, you know, one of the things we just got done with my men's group, and we had 15 guys online. I think it was the biggest men's group we've had ever. And it was all online, and I'm very grateful to have the access to the kind of internet that we're able to do video conferencing, because typically we meet in person and there's nothing like that. But I would say is that with the meeting in person, one of the things I was encouraged by is everybody's going through a little bit of a storm, right? We all have little stressors, and you know, whether your job's secure or not secure, whether you don't know how you're going to pay your bills and mortgage and all those things, whether you're worried about how many people are dying, and that's rightfully so, all things to think about. But I want to just try to give you a bit of calmness, and not to necessarily share with my story, but I also want to share with you what I read this morning. It was really appropriate, because as I was thinking about, I was really looking in the scripture and reading, and it pulled up these memories of me being in the storm. And I think in the verses, let me just pull this up, in the "So Will I," it's why it made me think of this. I can't remember exactly where the verse is there. And it was really like, it was the rocks. "If the rocks cry out in silence, so will I." Now I know there's like, "If the oceans roar your greatness, so will I." I mean, that's pretty cool. And it was interesting because that kind of contrasted to what I was reading. But the song is just such a calming song. If you're catching on now, go back and look at "So Will I" 100 billion times. Just this, such a great song. But in what I pulled up in scripture, and there's a different parts. It's in Matthew, it's in Mark, and I pulled it up in Matthew, where there's a time in the Bible where Jesus asks his disciples, guys that have been following him, and guys that actually are experienced sailors. So just let me preface this, because you might be experienced in a lot of things and you may have calmness in your life in a lot of areas, but then there's a storm like what's going on right now, and that can be really, really scary. But I wanted to share with you this. It's something, and I'll tell you what, it's really been amazing, because I've been wanting to dig in more scripture, because as I start to read it, something my pastor shares in his devotionals, he does a daily devotional, and he shares at the end of it, is when you start to dig into scripture, and when you start to read scripture, it starts to read you. And what's really awesome for believers, if you believe in what's true about the Bible, is that it's living. It's like alive. And what I love about it is that when you come back to it, it has different meanings at different seasons of your life. So with that, I wanted to just share with you and hear the point where it says, and let's see, where is it? Just see, oh, there it is. Jesus calms the storm. Jesus calming the storm. So he got in the boat and his disciples followed, and suddenly a furious storm came up on the lake, so the waves swept over the boat. But Jesus was sleeping. So this guy was sleeping in this boat, and the disciples went and he started to wake him up. He's like, hey, Lord, save me. He's like, save me on this. He's, you know, and all he replied was, "You have little faith. Why are you afraid?" And he's talking to like sailor dudes in this boat. So it was pretty cool. Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, And it was completely calm. And I'll tell you what, and there's been too many moments in my life at 47 where I felt not only has he, me leaning into my Heavenly Father and also other believers and people in a community, leaning into other community, family members, friends, leaning in during the storm to help calm that storm. So that's my thought for today. The daily dose I want to share with you of encouragement is helping you calm the storm. Now, whether you're a believer or not, is that you can go through this storm and let the waves and let this virus and be aware. Don't get me wrong. It's not to be ignorant of not knowing what's going on, but it's to understand that we're going to get through this. Just as I got through the storm when I was a kid and many storms in between, the storm when we lived here in my own home here in Florida, and we were able to get through that. And I believe now as well, regardless of how I'm affected, regardless of my specific personal circumstances, I truly believe that not only are we going to get through the storm, is that we're going to weather and be better off on the other side. And I would really encourage you now is if you're really struggling, if you're really having a difficult time, if you're struggling in a time where you don't know what's next, you don't know how you're going to feed your family, you don't know who's going to get sick, if you're going to get sick. My wife's a nurse practitioner. She goes into work. She's helping. She's on the front lines. And she's not working at hospitals. She just spent 6 hours yesterday doing training, online training, so that when she does go back, if they need her to help in the hospital, she's doing that right now. And there's a bit of concern for me, but I believe, and I know she does as well, is that our faith is going to get us through this regardless of our circumstances. So I just hope that as an encouragement to you, if it's something that you have enjoyed, I definitely welcome you to share this, the Daily Dose. I was thinking about just doing this on Monday through Friday, but I believe I'm going to commit to the entire month doing this. So every morning at 8 a.m., there's one day next week that I have to make it a little bit later, but for the most part, every morning, 8 a.m., I'm here for you. I want to give you a bit of encouragement. If you are feeling discouraged, come on tomorrow, 8 a.m. Side note, if you're getting discouraged about sitting around and not getting your workouts in, or maybe eating all the snacks and putting on the weight and all that, on a side note, that's what I do for a living. That's my livelihood. It's how I help pay my bills. If you need help, this could be a perfect time for you. I have even a perfect program because it doesn't require you to have access to a gym, even if it's with it's customized. It's called the Lean Body Breakthrough. So if you're worried about getting the heavy, having a breakthrough to more clothes that are bigger sizes and you're worried about this time right now, I would encourage you to reach out to me. We can talk. I specifically work with moms and dads, busy parents over 40 who are struggling, who want to truly change their lives without long workouts and a possible diet. So if that's something that you're interested, go ahead and send me a message. We'll hop on a quick call. We'll see if my program's the right fit for you. And I hope you've been enjoying the workouts that I posted. I also have a survival guide. I put together a COVID-19 fitness survival guide. So if you want access to that, send me a message and I'll send that over to you right away. Other than that, I hope you have a blessed, awesome, awesome day. And I hope your storm is calm today. Take care and God bless. We'll see you.